body stander over the top with one good arm attacking Michael Hayes. Scotty Steiner with one arm attacking Michael Hayes. The ref, wait a minute. Beautiful Bobby's a legal man. A referee didn't see it. Beautiful Bobby with the Alabama jam off the top on Rick Steiner. The referee didn't see it. Anderson's got the leg hook. Oh, no. They've won it.
Saturday night here on TBS. Jim Ross and Teddy Long with you, ladies and gentlemen. In this program, you're going to hear from Cowboy Bill Watts. He'll address the light heavyweight situation and the off-the-top rope rule. We're also going to see light heavyweights in action. We're going to see Marcus Bagwell take on Flying Brian also. We're going to see the former champion Brad Armstrong return to take on Scotty Flamingo. Plus, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the new television champion, takes on Vinny Vegas. We're going to hear from many of the top stars in the broadcast as well. I'm glad to have Teddy Long here with us. Teddy, you're a busy man. I know you've got a big function 1 week from today.
Well, Jim, just before we tell all the homies about that, let me thank all the homies for watching the all-new Power Hour and all the cards and letters that I've been getting thanking me, Tony Schiavone, Missy Hyatt, and Larry Zbyszko for the great job we're doing on the Power Hour right here on TBS. 1 week from today, I will be at the Mac Endry Elementary School. That'll be in Lawrenceville, Georgia, Jim. It's an all-day affair. I'll be giving away a lot of WCW merchandise and signing a lot of autographs for all the homies.
All right, Teddy, thanks very much, and keep up the good work. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring out one of the most dominant tag teams in the sport. From Bay City, Michigan, ladies and gentlemen, Rick and Scott Steiner. Let's welcome them here to WCW Saturday night. Rick and Scott making their way here to our interview area. It's always a pleasure to see the Steiner brothers here. And gentlemen, last week here on the program, a lot of people say it was an upset. I know you guys got one thing in your mind, and that's to take on Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton one more time right here on TV.
Well, you know, Jim Ross, me and my brother know a good Bobby Eaton and Arn Anderson, just like all these people out here. They're two of the greatest wrestlers to step in the ring. But you see, me and my brother have one goal, one common purpose, and that's to be world tag team champions once again. Well, to be able to wrestle for those belts, you got to be number one contender. So, Bobby and Arn, you guys are standing in our way. Next time we step in the ring, we're going to prove to you that we're just a little bit better. You know,
pretty good interview, eh?
You know, Arn Eaton, Anderson, you guys had a lot of things to prove. Me and my brother, we got one thing to prove. We want to be U.S. champions. Tonight here on TV, we're going to take you on. We want to finish this once and for all. Anderson, Eaton, me and my brother are ready. We got one thing standing our way. That's you two. We get done with you. We're going to the top for those WCW World Tag Team belts.
All right, those off-the-wall remarks from Rick Steiner and his brother Scott. Let's go up to Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, making his way into the ring area at 258 pounds from Hollywood, California, Stunning Steve Austin. He's accompanied to the ring by Paul E. Dangerously. Introducing his opponent at 225 pounds from Honolulu, Hawaii. This is Chris Sullivan.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're ready for one-on-one competition here. And indeed, the Steiner brothers are ready to take on Arn Anderson and beautiful Bobby Eaton today. If I got Rick Steiner's remarks, if I understood them correctly, they're ready to take them on anytime. Anderson and Eaton will be on this broadcast. They are not scheduled to wrestle the Steiners on this broadcast today, but the Steiners are here. We'll keep our eye on that situation. As Stunning Steve Austin, the man generally regarded as the greatest WCW television champion of all time. He lost the championship, as many of you are aware, to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. That was during the Clash of the Champions, as Austin now opens up offensively on Chris Sullivan here.
Austin working on the back of the head and the neck. We know that he likes to use his favorite offensive maneuver, that being the stun gun, where he snaps his opponent's head and neck right off the top rope. And that's what he's working on here. Austin has him up and drops him. Stunning Steve Austin, making short work of his opponent here today.
And the match, Stunning Steve Austin.
Stunning Steve Austin, no doubt, has his sights set on regaining the television title. Fans, don't forget, tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock, big action in Charleston, West Virginia. This Tuesday in Macon, Georgia. This Wednesday in Raleigh, North Carolina, as you see the stun gun. Perfectly done by Stunning Steve Austin.
I know that since the Clash of the Champions, you gentlemen have had one thing in your mind, that is regaining the television title.
Let's give credit where credit is due, Ricky Steamboat. You are the greatest athlete in the history of TBS. You are the best wrestler in the history of TBS. You are the most awe-inspiring athlete ever to grace the Superstation, with the exception of one man. And that man is the former and future World's Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
You know, my congratulations go out, Ross, to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat for his recent win at the Clash of Champions, because he not only beat the world's greatest athlete, but he beat the man who has held the World Television title longer than any man in the history of World Championship Wrestling. And you know, Ross, I can picture it right now, the scene at his house when he comes in the front door and he's got the TV title in the air and his kid runs up to him, jumping up and down, saying, "Oh, Daddy, let me hold it. Daddy, let me hold it." Slobbering all over the carpet. His wife's in there burning the turkey pot pies. So everything's hunky-dory, Ross. Live it up, Steamboat. Laugh and smile and joke and do whatever you want to do. Because remember, I have held this title longer than any man has done before. I know what it takes to hold the title, Steamboat, and so I also know what it takes to get it back. And Ross, that's exactly what I'll do.
Fans, there you hear from the former television champion, and when we come back, we'll hear comments from Cowboy Bill Watts. It's next on TBS. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. I'm here with Cowboy Bill Watts, the Vice President of Wrestling Operations for World Championship Wrestling. And, Bill, what are your thoughts regarding not only the Clash of Champions, but the voting of the fans on the off-the-top rope rule? And, of course, I'm sure all the fans are anxious to hear what the status is of the upcoming light heavyweight tournament.
Well, you've asked three things there. First of all, on the Clash, I was very excited because that's a prime-time live broadcast, and the ratings were fabulous. It jumped over a rating point. That's heavy competition. That means the fans are interested in WCW, and we want to thank everybody that tuned in. It was sure great to see the stars from the past, the future stars of the present. I really enjoyed the evening. The vote, the 900-number vote, that was a way to let the fans voice their opinion, and we're sensitive to that. We wanted a consensus, and we've got it. Now, what we've done is, with the Light Heavyweight Championship, which was a heart-rending situation with Bob there and his son Brad, and then the thing that happened with Flying Brian. But we are going to set a tournament. We'll announce the details or more details about that tournament in 2 weeks. However, for the fans that voted against the top rope rule, when we have the light heavyweight tournament on that date, the top rope rule will be rescinded in the light heavyweight division. And we are studying it as far as the heavyweight division. But it's still in effect until the tournament. And then the light heavyweight division, the top rope rule will be rescinded. And we want to thank everybody that took the time to tune in. And then we want to really thank the people that took the time to vote, because that's what it's all about. The fans are number one, and I want to thank them.
Bill, thank you very much. And we'll, of course, ladies and gentlemen, talk more about that situation as the hour progresses. We're going to see two top light heavyweights in action right now. Let's go back up to Rhubarb.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first at 229 pounds, from West Palm Beach, Florida, Scotty Flamingo. And his opponent from Marietta, Georgia, at 232 pounds, Brad Armstrong.
Two former light heavyweight champions getting it on here. And fans, let's take a quick look back
Remember, at the Clash of the Champions, you will see exactly what has transpired involving Flying Brian as he literally slapped the taste right out of the mouth of the former light heavyweight champion. And we're going to see Armstrong, or excuse me, Pillman, take on Marcus Alexander Bagwell a little bit later in the program. Two former light heavyweight champions in action right here in Flamingo and Armstrong. Flamingo with the advantage here. Goes far as, and going for Armstrong's knee there, and Armstrong obviously very sensitive of that situation. It was on July 5th that Brad Armstrong defeated Scotty Flamingo and Atlanta's Omni to win the title. It was on September the 2nd that Brad was stripped of the title for physically being unable to defend it. Great counter move by Armstrong. Spinning out of the pressure, floats over to the armbar. So we'll know more about the tournament in a couple of weeks here on WCW Saturday Night. And once the tournament starts in the light heavyweight division only, the off-the-top rope rule will be rescinded. Both arms hooked. Armstrong going for the pin here. And got two out of near fall. Drop toe by Brad. Again floats over into the armbar. Brad was so brokenhearted that he was stripped of the championship. WCW really was lenient in the decision as far as giving him an extension of the time. As Flamingo comes to that right hand, and Armstrong again counters very quickly, this time into the wrist lock. Brad's father, Bob, was here, as Cowboy Bill Watts mentioned, his family looking on. In addition to the nationwide television audience, his opportunity to defend his world title right here on the station he grew up on, TBS, but that was not to be, and the actions of Flying Brian certainly shocked us all. And I know it has Brad very concerned. Good move there by Brad Armstrong. Arm drag takeover. I think Brad considered himself a good friend of Flying Brian, and perhaps still considers himself a friend of the former light heavyweight champion. In any event, it is a very competitive division, and I'm anxious to see the pairings and the formula for this tag team tournament. As I said, we'll know that in a couple of weeks right here on TBS. Flamingo showing a real aggressive streak, and now he's kicking that leg, working on the knee. Armstrong has both knees braced, trying to camouflage the injured knee, but Flamingo has it pointed out here, and now going to work on it. Spinning leg lock. Armstrong's got the inside cradle. He had him locked up, and I thought he had it. He had two out of it. And Flamingo very quickly up, right back to work on the leg. That leg is far from healed, but Armstrong not making any excuses. He wanted to compete here. He wanted to test his knee. And he's in there with a tough light heavyweight and the former champion. Armstrong with the forearm. Found his mark there. Irish whip to the far side. He buried the right hand in the midsection. And there's that knee lift, thunderous knee lift, reminiscent of Mr. Wrestling 2. Flamingo bears that shoulder right into the abdomen, and he Irish whips Armstrong across. Armstrong, the great quickness. Flamingo swinging wildly. Armstrong got the rope, side rush and leg sweep. He hooked it. That's how he won the title, and he wins it here.
The winner of the match, Brad Armstrong.
Brad Armstrong from nearby Marietta, Georgia. Fans in Atlanta, don't forget, WCW back in the Omni on Sunday, September 20th at 7:30. That's Sunday, September 20th at 7:30. And Brad is calling for Rhubarb's mic.
Flying Brian. I know you're here, Flying Brian. You and I have a problem, brother. You and I have a problem we need to straighten out right away. At the Clash of the Champions, Flying Brian, you slapped my jaws, brother. Well, I'm gonna give you the benefit of a doubt, and I'm gonna give you the chance to come out here and explain this to me face to face. So come on out, Brian. Come on out here and face me face to face.
Well, the challenge has been issued. Let's see if Pillman comes out. I don't see him right now. Well, I'm not so sure he's gonna make it right now. Fans, we've gotta take a break. We'll be back right after you listen to this. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Jim Ross back with the United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude, the number one contender for the world's heavyweight title. But we haven't had a chance to talk with you personally since your defeat at the hands of Masahiro Chono in the finals of the NWA tournament. What are your thoughts looking back at that situation?
My thoughts are this, Ross. I not only demand a return match for the NWA title, but I deserve a return match for the title. You're looking at a man who almost overcame the insurmountable odds. And I'm not talking about the horrible case of jet lag I suffered on the way to Tokyo, the horrible food or the cramped living conditions. I'm not even talking about the capacity crowd that jammed the Sumo Palace every night to pull against Ravishing Rick Rude. On that particular night, there wasn't a person in the country of Japan or the world who could stop Ravishing Rick Rude except one man. And that man's name was not Chono, it was Hattori, the referee who forgot to count three when I had Chono beat.
It sounds like that sour grapes to me.
It might sound like sour grapes, Ross, but the tape speaks for itself.
There was some very controversial moments in that contest, but tomorrow here on the main event, we're going to see your semifinal matchup against Kensuke Sasaki, one of the great young stars in Tokyo.
That's right. Sasaki is probably the greatest young star in Japan today. But you see, on five successive nights, I faced and defeated all the top competitors in the world. The only man in the tournament who didn't draw a bye on the way to the finals. Sasaki's problem was he was one of my victims.
We'll see that matchup tomorrow on the main event, but I have to wonder, are you going to lobby with WCW officials about this rematch?
You better believe it, Ross. It's like this. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. We're not going to let the same things happen again. Deuce and I are pushing pretty hard for a few stipulations. Not to put the ball in our court, or to put the odds in our favor, just to make everything on the up and up. Because if everything's on an even keel, there's not a man in the world today that can beat Ravishing Rick Rude.
Fans, there you hear it from the United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude, and we'll have more of WCW Saturday Night right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, at 280 pounds, from Bangkok, Super Invader. Introducing his opponent already in the ring at 232 pounds, he hails from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Shane Douglas.
Young Shane Douglas returning to WCW. He's got a tall order ahead of him here. Being outweighed 48 pounds in this contest, a tough way to debut. And Douglas has got to use his quickness and expertise here to stay away from the power. And there you see the power right there out of the collar and elbow tie-up of that huge man, the Super Invader. Good quickness there by Douglas. Didn't allow himself to get caught in the corner. Young man from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Super Invader forces him back into the corner. And misses with that big right hand. We'll have our first Halloween Havoc Control Center here next week. Some of the top main event matches that you'll see exclusively on pay-per-view October 25th will be announced right here next Saturday. And the Super Invader, as we expected now, opening up the advantage here on this youngster. Douglas weighed in at 232, as we mentioned. Super Invader at least 280. He may be closer to that 290 mark. Straight right hand. Sends him for the ride. Great quickness by Shane Douglas. Comes back up with some right hands of his own. Douglas showing that he's not intimidated on this big man. And he had that right hand ready for war. And a U-turn by the masked man. A very aggressive offensive flurry there by Shane Douglas. Referee Mike Atkins using his 10 count. Super Invader makes his way back into the ring. And now wants to lock up. Tested. Oh, he caught him. He sucker punched him with that right hand. He got it in too, right below the eye. Super Invader dictating the pace. Big time Irish whip, but Douglas caught him coming in. And a power slam. He's got him right here. No, he doesn't. He got kicked out at two. Thought he had him right there. We talked about that almost 50-pound weight advantage. And he set a little early, and Douglas got a kick in. Irish whip going left to right now, and he caught him in the belly to belly. He caught him. Can he hold him? He's got the leg up, and he beat him. He beat him.
The winner of the match, Shane Douglas.
Well, you got to call that one an upset. Let's see if we get this kid over here. I know we've got to go to the break. Let's talk to Shane Douglas. Come on over. We'll take another look at exactly what happened. Shane Douglas with that belly-to-belly suplex, and that planted a big mash man. He hooks the leg, and it's over. And I got to tell you, young man, I knew you were coming back to WCW, but in my opinion, this was an upset, and congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much, Jim Ross. But thank you, each and every one of you sitting here tonight, because without you, it can't be done.
I tell you, I know that you've got a lot of lofty goals, but when you saw your name in the contract against a guy that outweighs you 50 pounds, you had to have some second thoughts.
Jimmy Ross, when you're talking about professional wrestling and the very best, you've got to talk about World Championship Wrestling. You've got to talk about the very best wrestlers of the world. Your Cactus Jacks, your Van Vaders, and oh yes, your Super Invaders. Oh, Rusty, when I saw my name on the dotted line for the Super Invader, no doubt, I knew I had to be fired up to reach the ultimate goal. That's to be the best in World Championship Wrestling. A lot of great wrestlers. But with your support out here, I'm going to make it right to the top.
All right, thanks very much. Congratulations once again, fans. We'll be back, an exciting young man, and we'll be back with more right after this timeout. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to WCW Saturday Night. I'm here with Cactus Jack and the Barbarian, the very same spot we stood on at the Clash of Champions when you introduced this man and his new tag team partner, Hacksaw Butch Reed. You mentioned Ron Simmons' name in that conversation. I'm sure you've been thinking a lot about Ron Simmons in recent days.
Oh, yeah. Ron Simmons, great athlete, world champion. Simmons, you didn't get that belt around your waist by luck. No! You beat a great man. And since you've had that belt, you haven't ducked anybody. You beat Cactus Jack! You beat Cactus Jack! You beat Cactus Jack. But take a good look, Ron. No more tears. No, Cactus Jack's crying time's over because I got the truth on my side. And the truth is that your championship world is about to come crumbling down beside you. Somewhere, somehow, Ron, you put down the posing oil. You stop kissing that belt and find the guts to sign with either this man, the Barbarian, or your old partner, Butch Reed. The Barbarian, there's something explosive in his leg. He's been running through all competition, and he could take you out. But Butch Reed, he knows you better than anybody. He knows where you live. He knows how you think. And come Halloween Havoc, Ron, you make the choice. One way or the other, your title's going down. And Ron, get your lip marks off our belt. Bang, 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 bang.
Fans, let's go to the ring and see the Barbarian in action.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring at 299 pounds, from parts unknown, the Barbarian. And introducing his opponent already in the ring at 203 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, Ricky Nelson.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, young Ricky Nelson has the inimitable opportunity to meet the Barbarian, one of the men that certainly is indeed in the heavyweight title picture.
I'll tell you what, Ross, we're going to make things real simple out here. He is no longer Ricky Nelson. He is Ron Nelson. I'm gonna make things easy for you. I'm gonna make them easy for me because we are geared towards one goal. That's Ron Simmons, the World Heavyweight Champion. And down goes Ron Nelson. He's not gonna take the Barbarian out with a move like that.
Fans, don't forget tomorrow in the main event, Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes take on the Barbarian and Cactus Jack in tag team action. We've also talked about Ravishing Rick Rude and Kintsuke Sasaki, that match tomorrow with Michael Hayes and me on the main event at 6:05 Eastern time. Oh.
What this is right here is a test. It's a test of will for really little Ron Nelson, just like tomorrow night's going to be a test of will for Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham, because you're looking at two dangerous men. You're looking at a dangerous man.
Well, I'm sure that Ron Simmons is not going to back away from any challenges. Nelson's throwing all the artillery he's got, but to no avail. Look at the strength of this man. He just walked out from under him here.
I'm also sure that if Ron Simmons has a brain in his little head, that he better be looking right here for the Barbarian, because like I said, there's something explosive in that boot. Bingo!
Man, he kicked him right in the face. Nelson is out of it.
The winner of the match, the Barbarian.
The Barbarian stomping that foot and then putting the kid's lights out. Something explosive in the foot. And maybe more ways than one. What a challenge for Simmons, whether it would be with a Barbarian or with Hacksaw
Reed. Here it is, like you see it, easily pressing young Ron Nelson over his head, letting him go, letting him go. And now we have it, the big boot. And that boot, I guarantee you one thing, has Ron Simmons' name on it. 1, 2, 3, that belt is ours.
Fans, when we come back, we'll take another look at Halloween Havoc right after this timeout. Welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. Still to come, we're going to see Marcus Alexander Bagwell take on Flying Brian Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Will defend his newly won television title. But right now, let's take another look at that very special feature that many of you saw at the Clash of the Champions. It's all about spin the wheel, make the deal. Jake Roberts and Sting, no doubt, at Halloween Havoc can settle their situation once and for all. Perhaps, ladies and gentlemen, a career-ending situation. 12 dangerous choices in this matchup. Let's take a look at this feature.
I knew you'd come. It was just a matter of time.
Yeah, I'm here, so what's the deal?
Sting, I'm going to finish what I started in Baltimore. When I get done with you, you wish you'd never been born.
You talk too much. Get to the point. What's the deal?
Sting, relax. What's your hurry? I'm gonna take my time and enjoy this moment.
Cut the crap. Do I have to come over there and kick your ass?
Sting, you don't get it, do you, man? You don't have a clue. Look around you. This is my playground. These are my people. I'm smiling, not you. It's come down to this. You see, the deal is on the wheel. At Halloween Havoc, your worst nightmare will come true. 12 of the toughest and most brutal matches in wrestling.
That's right. That's right. Brutal. Brutal.
You see on the wheel, there's a cage match. There's a barbed wire match. There's a death match. Or there might even be a mystery match. But you see, the deal is, man, you gotta step up and spin that wheel. Once you spin it, where it stops, that's what you and I are gonna do. And what happens? Well, we both go in the ring. One man comes out. The other? Well, no.
You think I'm afraid of some wheel? You think I'm afraid of you?
Step out of the fog, Sting. Clear your head. You're not thinking. I'm the master of all these matches. This is no game for me. This is fun, but it's not a game. We play it on my turf and my terms. So good luck, Sting. You're gonna need it.
So what are you waiting for? Let's do it now.
To be continued.
We're here with the former WCW Light Heavyweight Champion, Scotty Flamingo, who no doubt will be involved in the upcoming Light Heavyweight Tournament, but you didn't have a great deal of success earlier in the program.
Scotty Flamingo gets in a ring with Brad Armstrong, kicks out a two, and the referee counts three. I mean, what is this? Some kind of pity party for Brad Armstrong because he didn't have the guts to defend the belt the other night, and they stripped him of it, and so he's gonna take it out on Flamingo? Well, I'll tell you what, World Light Heavyweight Title Tournament coming up, Scotty Flamingo, the former champion, you will see the belt around his waist again.
I know you've got more to say, and we'll let you talk some more in just a moment. Right now, let's go back up to Rhubarb.
First, from Cincinnati, Ohio, at 228 pounds, Flying Brian!
Flying Brian, not the most popular man right now, CW, the former light heavyweight champion, who uncharacteristically and for
maybe the single best thing Pillman's ever done.
Well, that may be your opinion. I don't think you'd find many people to agree with you.
You know, after that.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing at 231 pounds from Marietta, Georgia, Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
Fans, while we have a moment, don't forget, 1 week from tonight, a great WCW event in Philadelphia. And then 1 week from tomorrow night, that's Sunday, September 20th, 7:30, WCW will return here to Atlanta in the Omni. And the bell has sounded here.
You know, this should be an interesting matchup, Jim Ross, because let's see, Brian Pillman showed me something the other night at the Clash when he slapped Brad Armstrong's face. And you know, the thing that really puzzled me was Brad Armstrong's father, Bob, was there begging and pleading with the kid. He practically punched the kid in the face, begging him to go in the ring and defend the belt, but the kid didn't have any guts. So now I'm interested to see if Brian Pillman's going to keep up with what he did the other night and do it right here again to Bagwell.
Well, I haven't heard the rendition of that particular story, but be that as it may, that is your opinion, as Bagwell has a side headlock on Flying Brian Pillman. Good shoulder block by Bagwell. Very fast-paced match. Good counter move by Bagwell. Arm drag takeover. Bagwell getting the better of Pillman in the early going.
Well, I give Bagwell credit. He is the rookie sensation, quote unquote. But I'll tell you what, Flying Brian's been in the sport a long time, Jim Ross. He's been the former World Light Heavyweight Champion. He's the man that I, personally, Scotty Flamingo, beat for the belt. And I don't think Bagwell's going to be able to, I don't think he's going to pass the muster tonight.
Well, Pillman's been an always intense athlete, but slapping someone in the face in their most down moment was totally uncalled for. Good arm drag takeover.
There you go, Jim Ross. Bagwell got a little advantage. Pillman got a little cocky. But look, oh, he's asking for a handshake. Oh, and a knee in the gut. Fabulous, Jim Ross. Fabulous.
Pillman just throwing sportsmanship out the window, and then at the same time, he's turning his back on his fans. Brad Armstrong out here earlier. What a chop there by Pillman. Trying to get Brian to come to the ring to perhaps patch up this situation, clear the air. But Pillman refused to do it earlier in this broadcast.
You know, Jim Ross, a one.
He's got a cover there.
Just a one count. You know, after this display by Pillman, I almost feel bad that I had to beat him for the World Light Heavyweight title in the first place.
Pillman cinches up on that reverse chin lock.
Gotta cinch it in tight. That's what a lot of the fans at home don't realize. That what you're doing is you're cutting off the oxygen to the brain, and the opponent can't think then, and that's when he makes the costly mistakes.
I just can't see with Armstrong's father here, his family here, and he loses his world title due to an injury, can't unable to defend the title, and then slapping him in the face on live national television was, I don't know, I think was totally uncalled for.
I tell you, Jim Ross, I seen Bob Armstrong in the VIP room. I was up there schmoozing, mingling about.
True, what chops? And look at Bagwell fight back, but Pillman comes back with those chops, and Bagwell retaliates.
They're just going toe-to-toe, Jim Ross.
Pillman just thumbed him right in the eye. Lion Bryan thumbed him right in the eye. Pillman on the second.
Oh, and a gut shot!
He was met with that fist right to the gut as he came off the second rope. And now Bagwell opening up offensively. It's the reversal of the Irish whip. And Bagwell takes Pillman face first down.
A face full of canvas for Flying Bryan. Bagwell's got to get on him and stay on him if he wants to take the victory here. A drop kick in the midsection. And a cover.
He's going for the cover here. Hooks the leg. And 2.5 there. Bagwell a half a count away from beating Flying Bryan. And Pillman. Look at Pillman back away. Pillman.
And they're both over the top, Jim Ross. They're both over the top rope. Bagwell took a terrible spill on his head down there.
Referee makes a judgment call there, signaling that both men went over the top. A no call, in essence.
Look at the maniacal look on Flying Bryan. He's like a man repossessed out there, Jim Ross. Look at his face.
He ran and just kicked the kid in the head. Bagwell hurt on the floor, trying to crawl back in, and Pillman kicks him coming in and pins him.
How about that, Jim Ross?
The winner of the match.
Fantastic.
All right, Scotty, well, thanks for being with us. Wait a minute, there's Brad Armstrong back out here. Bagwell got kicked right in the head, and now Armstrong's back out here. Let's listen to this.
Flying Bryan, brother, you wouldn't come to me, so I thought I'd come to you. I think it's about time we got the air cleared, fella. Now, I know the Clash of Champions, you are a little not too clear-headed, okay? And I'll give you the benefit of the doubt, and I'm gonna give you this opportunity, and I'm gonna say, Bryan, brother, put her there. We can clear the air right now.
Oh, my. Pillman slapped him again and is laughing in his face. Armstrong is trying to. Oh, and Armstrong nails Pillman. Armstrong on top of Pillman, and Flamingo's in. Scotty Flamingo in from behind. Here comes Bagwell. All four light heavyweights are getting it on. Flamingo goes to the outside. Flying Bryan's on the outside. What a crazy situation here, fans. We'll be back after this. Don't go away. This is WCW Saturday Night. Crowd here still buzzing over what we saw involving those four light heavyweights, but it's always a pleasure to talk to the natural Dustin Rhodes. And Dustin, I know that you and Barry Windham had great success in tag team wrestling. What are your future plans as far as tag teams are concerned?
Well, I've known Barry Windham a long time, and we work pretty good together. I've known him all my life, and he's taught me a whole lot in my professional wrestling career. And what we would like right now more than anything is to be the World Tag Team Champions. And that day will come. We're ready. I think Barry's ready. I know we're ready. So when that day comes, whoever's the champions better watch out.
And right now, of course, that's Dr. Ness, Steve Williams, and Terry Bam Bam Gordy. But looking at your individual career, what's on your mind as far as individual goals?
Well, a lot of people want to conquer the world. I myself don't want to conquer the world just yet. I want to take each day step by step. And that step is around Ravishing Rick Rude's waist. That's the United States heavyweight title and belt. Ravishing Rick Rude, right now, I'm going to go on record. I want your United States heavyweight title around my waist, and I'm initiating a challenge to you. It's very simple, Ravishing Rick Rude. I think I'm ready. I know I'm ready. I know my father thinks I'm ready. I know these fans know that I'm ready. And Ravishing Rick Rude, I'm challenging you right now. United States title.
All right, Dustin, I know you're ready as well. No doubt about that. We saw on the monitor a young man that's been training a great deal, a young man that was your host when you were on a recruiting trip at the University of Louisville, Eric Watts. How's his training going?
Well, Eric's been training real hard. You know, I've worked with him. Barry's worked with him. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. He's doing real good. Hey, Eric, why don't you come on down here?
Eric Watts over there in the stands. Let's see if we can get him over here, ladies and gentlemen. We haven't had the opportunity here on WCW Saturday Night to talk to Eric. Of course, the son of Cowboy Bill Watts, former quarterback for the University of Louisville. Well, Louisville tried it one more time against Ohio State. They came real close. I know you remember that game last year, but let's don't talk about football. Let's talk about how your training's going in wrestling.
Well, this being the most demanding sport I've ever played in, I've had to train double tough, but with people like Dustin, Barry Windham, and Steamboat, you know, my training's coming ahead of its time, and I'm ready to get in there, and like my father said, let's hook them up, you know?
Aren't we taking up some valuable TV time?
Well, it's pretty valuable, Dustin.
Well, Rook, let's get out of here.
All right, he's taking the Rook with him, ladies and gentlemen. Dustin Rhodes and Eric Watts to the Outstanding Young Stars. We'll look forward to Eric's debut right here on the broadcast in the next few weeks. But right now, let's go back up to our good friend Rhubarb Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for the World TV title. It is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing the World's TV champion at 236 pounds from Charlotte, North Carolina, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And introducing the challenger at 302 pounds. From Las Vegas, Nevada, Vinny Vegas.
Vinny Vegas at 302 to challenge the new television champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat here. One fall, the 15-minute time limit. Don't forget to join Tony Schiavone, Larry Zbysko, Teddy Long, and Missy Hyatt for the all-new Power Hour every Saturday morning at 9:05 here on TBS. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat facing a huge man in Vinny Vegas who has improved each and every time we've seen him in the last several weeks. Tremendous athlete. Good shoulder block. Side headlock, you see he's got a size, strength, and leverage advantage on the Dragon. Steamboat's really good at their use his great techniques here. Steamboat dropped toe hold. Great move, taking the big man down. Steamboat with a side headlock. And there you hear Steamboat say, man, he's a big one. No doubt that he is. Steamboat's gonna have to try to mat wrestle this man. At least control the tempo here. Make that big guy move that 302 pounds as rapidly as he can for as long as he can until Steamboat can position him into a pinning predicament. Vegas trying to counter perhaps with a belly to back suplex there. He saw him try to pick that leg. Steamboat took it away. The all new Power Hour crew will set in for me tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB. There's a crucifix, good move there. Steamboat trying to get him down and but Vegas caught his balance, gained physical control, and then a reverse slam there on Steamboat. And you never know exactly the status of Steamboat's ribs. They still gotta be sore because he took very little time off. And there's a side slam, and they could be completely healed and re-injured here. A lot of power and leverage displayed by Vegas. Great right hand hitting down at Steamboat. Steamboat chopping up those martial arts blows on Big Vinny Vegas, who caught Steamboat again with that knee. Stunning Steve Austin. Very, very focused and very aggressive in his remarks regarding Steamboat. There's the elbow. Hey, this can be over right here. He got 2.5 right there. That elbow went right in the solar plexus and Steamboat's in trouble. The Dragon's got to fight back with all he's got here. Vegas with that knee again, right to the chest and ribs. And now that big foot right to the neck and the throat. As Vegas scoops him up very, very easily and slams him with a great deal of velocity. Up on that second rope, man, he's a huge man. And Steamboat caught him coming off. The Dragon reacted there with a good counter move, the best move he could come up with, and it was effective. Steamboat having to leap in the air to get the martial arts on the man's head. Irish whip, left to right. He chopped him. And he staggered the big man who's about 7 feet tall, close to it. Irish whips him in, but he got caught coming in. The Dragon was caught coming in with that foot. And Vegas again using his right hand very effectively. Has Steamboat up. What's he gonna do with him here? He's on his shoulder. Vegas, oh, he's gonna go for snake eyes. He wants to drop him face first on the turnbuckle, but Steamboat, he countered it. Steamboat's got him rolled up. Can he hold the big man? And yes, he does.
The winner and still World Universal's TV champion, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Great victory for Steamboat. And fans, when we come back, we'll talk to the WCW World's Heavyweight Champion, Ron Simmons. That's next on TBS. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And please welcome the man that graces the cover of the current edition of WCW Magazine. And more importantly, he is the WCW Heavyweight Champion of the World, the one and only Ron Simmons, making his way here to the ring. Ron, how you doing? Great to see you again. You're the cover of the magazine. I know you're a wanted man as far as the championships are concerned. The man that's on your trail, the number one contender's Ravishing Rick Rude.
Yes, he is, Jim, and you know what? There's been a trail of them so far, and they're coming out of woodwork. But like I said, you know, hey, I'll take on everyone that signs that dotted line because I'm the kind of champion that, hey, I give every man his opportunity. And unlike in the past, you know, Rick Rude is the number one contender, and in the past there have been one-dimensional type of wrestlers, such as Cactus Jack, do-anything type of wrestler. Big Van Vader, a big bullish type of wrestler. But I've never been one to cut a man short. I'll give a man his due. And Rick Rude has ring time. The man has strength. He's versatile. And I'll give it to him. I'm going to have to go back, get into the training room, sharpen up on my skills, because this is going to be by far the biggest test, the best challenge that Ron Simmons has had in his wrestling career.
I know you got to watch out for that Rude Awakening, but also coming up at Halloween Havoc. And I know you've got some goals set for yourself for Halloween Havoc.
Well, for one thing for sure. This being the biggest event of all during the rest my wrestling career, and being as champion now, when I get into Halloween Havoc, I want to still have this belt around my waist. I want to headline that card as the World Heavyweight Champion.
All right, Ron, thanks very much. It's going to be the greatest pay-per-view in the history of wrestling on October 25th. As Ron Simmons makes his way from our interview area, fans, let's go back up to Rhubarb.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, making their way to the ring area, accompanied by Michael P.S. Hayes, with a combined weight of 489 pounds, from Huntsville, Alabama, beautiful Bobby, and from Minneapolis, Minnesota, Double A, Arn Anderson. And introducing their opponents with a combined weight of 442 pounds, Kevin Neal and Robert Wallace.
Fans, don't forget, tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB, the entire all-new Power Hour crew will set in for yours truly while I'll be in Washington, D.C. for the Falcons-Redskins game. I've been joined here by Michael P.S. Hayes. And Michael Hayes, we heard some comments, some very strong comments, albeit somewhat irreverent, from the Dog-Faced Gremlin. They want you guys. They want you badly.
Well, they can want all they want. It's an old story. It's over with. We beat them last week, and we took the number one contender spot. The story now is Terry Bam Bam Gordy and Dr. Death back from Japan, and I know his flaw. He knows I know his flaw, and I promise you, they know it now. Speaking of Bobby and Arn.
Arn Anderson, shades out of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, so much tag team heritage when you get these two guys together. And everywhere I went last week, I covered the Falcons game with the New York.
Yes. Mets.
They were all talking about the Steiners losing to Anderson Neaton.
Well, I'm sorry. It was an upset in some people's eyes. I called it. I said it was going to happen. These two guys are the greatest tag team wrestlers. Steiners are no lightweights. They've got the best record ever in WCW, but they're not the number one contenders. It's over. Terry, it's you now. It's you and Doc.
Great tag team work here by Anderson and Eaton, tagging in and out. Looks like they're going for submission here, working on the arm of the young man. This is a very sadistic team.
Ha!
Man, that is a brutal maneuver. He's
it's
got
over.
That wide base.
It's
he's
over.
Got it wrenched in.
It's
and
over.
The kid says, I quit. I quit. It's over. Yet another submission victory for the number one contenders for the World Tag Team titles. Fans, this is our Jolly Rancher Colossal Crunch Instant Replay. Jolly Rancher Candies, the great taste of fruit square. All right, Michael, a submission victory. Obviously, your sights set on Williams and Gordy, but you better not forget about the Steiner brothers.
The Steiners can forget it. It's over. We beat you last week. Enough said. Terry Bam Bam Gordy. What? Hey, they say, what do you got to take on you guys to be for the World Tag Titles? I can beat you. I can beat you. I can beat
beat you, and I know I can beat you. Let's do it right now.
Well, he's made a challenge, gentlemen. Is Hayes going to fight Rick Steiner? Rick Steiner without his brother. He came out. He wants to take either one another. Scotty Steiner. The Steiner brothers are ready.